Hi, everybody. We have another one of our University Libraries Collectors interviews ready for you today. Today, we're going to be talking with Suzanne Sawyer. Suzanne is the Preservation Specialist in Preservation Services, which is part of SCUA. So, Suzanne, tell us a little bit about your collection. What do you collect?
All right. Well, I collect historical bookbinding models. So in case people aren't aware of what those are, basically it's looking at historic book structures and creating models of those structures to kind of, by recreating one to better understand how it's put together, how it's created historically, how craftsmen did that sort of work. So,
yeah. So how did you start that collection? How long have you been collecting and what got you interested in this work?
Well, I actually for about 20 years, I've been doing bookbinding. So I took a afternoon workshop. I was a teacher in LA and there was an afternoon workshop for teachers that I took. And I thought this bookbinding thing is really cool. I'm going to see if there's anything else like that out there, not realizing the incredible subculture of bookbinders there are all over the world. But anyway, from there, I ended up taking bookbinding class after bookbinding workshop and had what I call my drive-by education in bookbinding, where I took a class here and there, shot in the dark kind of thing. And then in 2010, I ended up getting my, or starting an MFA in book arts, which included bookbinding. And it was then that I started creating models of historical structures.
Very cool. So I know it's always hard to ask for a favorite, but can you tell us a little bit about one of your favorite or most prized items in the collection?
Sure. I'm actually, if it's okay, I'll talk briefly about a couple of them. So this is one of the first ones. So this is a pretty small volume, you can see by the size of my hand. And this is a historical structure. It's a model of St. Cuthbert's Gospel, or also known as the Stonyhurst Gospel. Basically, it's laminated boards. There's leather over the boards, and you can see there's kind of a raised cover underneath the leather. This binding is based on the oldest Western bookbinding known to still have existed. So St. Cuthbert, he died, I think, in the late 7th century, and about a few years later, a copy of St. Cuthbert's Gospel, which is, I think, the Gospel of John, was put in the tomb with him. And that's actually, because it was in the tomb with him, what made it last a little bit longer, because it was protected from the elements and that kind of thing. So that's one of them. I also have made this. This is a model of a Italian accounting book, actually, during the really like the 15th to 17th, or actually 14th to 17th century. There were these daily account books. This is a parchment cover. You can see there's leather on top and then this lacing. I don't know if you can see in the camera, there's lacing. And then on the spine, tacketing, this is vellum. So vellum is made from calfskin, which is like parchment's kind of the overarching term that covers both of it. But anyway, what's really cool about these books is that they're sewn on these tabs you can see inside the structure. And they would use them for accounting books or for diaries and that kind of thing. So they were created as blank books, but then they could add sections on at the back. So if you were doing your accounting for your business or whatever, and you needed more paper in there, you could just sew on more sections. So they were made with these longer flaps that would wrap around, or that would also wrap around more sections of the book. So that one's kind of a fun one just because of the decorative lacing and so forth. And then the last one I'll tell you about, this one is a model of one of the Nag Hammadi codices. So the Nag Hammadi codices were these Gnostic gospels that were found in a clay jar in 1945. And it's a really interesting story. So if you're interested, read it. But basically these two brothers found 13, I think, codices in a jar and basically decided they were going to sell one at a time or whatever. But it turns out their mother burnt some of them in a fire. So they actually didn't all exist. She decided that, you know, it was bad to have that text around for whatever from the Gnostic Gospels, that it might not be a good thing. But they were, there were about 13 of them. This is a model of the sixth codex. So you can see it was made, this is imitation, papyrus in there, but it was made with papyrus pages. There's a little bit of real papyrus there in the cover that you can see that was laminated pieces that made the cover covered in leather. This extra section that I'm holding is actually a copy of the 13th Codex. So the 13th Codex was found just as a loose section stuck inside the sixth one. So that's what this represents. So we went into the whole detail of even including the 13th Codices and or Codex in there with the sixth. But anyway, that was just kind of cool. The history around the Nag Hammadi Codices is really interesting. There have been books and I think fictional stories and all kinds of things just because it's such a neat thing. But anyway, so that those are three of my favorites.
That's very cool. Thank you so much for sharing that with us.
Yeah, thanks for asking me.